Okay, so this is the last part of the course 7 on generative model of networks, and in this last part we will see the preferential attachment model. It's again something that you already heard of in the course 3b part 6, and this model of preferential attachment is sometimes called Barabasi-Albert model in the name of its two inventors. Here it's a network model that that describes the growth of a network, and so this model, it simply describes how the nodes are added. They are added progressively, and when we simulate it, we make simulation steps, and within each step a node is added. And the idea of preferential attachment is that you will create links, so you will attach to some nodes more frequently than the others. In fact, new nodes, at each time one new node is created, and this node will preferably connect with the other nodes that have a high degree. In fact, this model is based on a very common mechanism in modeling in general, sometimes called the accumulated advantage effect, or the Matthew effect, or the sentence of the rich get richer. And it just says that already highly connected nodes, so nodes with already a high degree, will have even more chance to be connected with new nodes, so they will keep the advantage of being of high degree, and this advantage allows us for them to again increase their own advantage, so the advantage is reinforced by the mechanism. So in mathematics you can explain the probability to choose a node G by the fraction of its degree divided by the sum of the degree of the other nodes of the network. So this is for this probability is for every other node in the network, and when you create a new node, you draw a random number into this kind of distribution, and you will have more chance to connect with a node of high degree. It can be shown that the degree distribution of the graph tends to follow a power law distribution. So this is how we will detect it if we find some scale-free model, because this preferential attachment model produces a scale-free network, so a network whose degree distribution tends to follow a power law. Again, a little demonstration of the model with NetLogo. So I fire up NetLogo. Okay, I go under the model library in networks and I take the preferential attachment model. Okay, so a couple of buttons. Setup initiates the model by creating an edge between two nodes, and go once, add one node, and each time the node is added, it will choose among the other nodes with a preference towards highly connected nodes. So if I do that a couple of times, you see that the network start to look like a network with a lot of stars. So for example, this node is very central, and this button is useful because it will resize the size of the nodes according to the degree. So big nodes mean big degree. This model has also a layout to apply a forced spring force directed algorithm of layout to make the network look more beautiful. So you see it's a very tree-like structure. In fact, it's a tree, it can be shown. You observe the degree distribution here, so you observe that there is a lot of nodes that have a low degree of 1, and there is one node that has a degree of 13. And in fact, if you do that a lot of time, so you click on Go and you just watch the network growing, you will see that the inequality in the degree distribution will increase a lot. So there is very few nodes with a high degree, but there is a lot of nodes that has a very low degree. So to better observe this kind of distribution, we drew the degree distribution in a log-log plot. And you see that the dots start to form a power law, because in a log-log referential, the straight line that you can observe forming here denotes a power law between the two quantities. So basically, this is it for the model. Let's have a look at the code, maybe. You will see. So this code creates the nodes, and we should look at the find partner procedure. Okay, so you can look at the code here to understand how the code the model is built. Okay, that's it pretty much for this course. So generative models of networks are good models because usually they are simple, or at least these two models, the preferential attachment and the Barabasi-Albert model, the same, sorry, the Watt-Strogatz model and the Barabasi-Albert model, are simple models that are easy to understand and easy to implement. So for that, they are good because simple models can be quickly seized and quickly implemented in the R software or in NetLogo or any programming language. I strongly encourage you to look at the code and the documentation of the models in NetLogo to grasp the basic ideas, because we will use that in the tutorial. And these are the three famous publications that describe the models we have seen in this course. So thank you for your attention, and see the tutorials to try to make the same kind of models with NetLogo. Bye.